गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू जीएसएस कोर, दिस इज अजय शाह। सो आई होप यू ऑल आर एंजॉयिंग दिस सेशन एंड वी हैव ऑलमोस्ट कवर्ड दिस सेशन। टुडे इज द सेकंड लास्ट क्लास ऑफ आवर दिस सेशन, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द क्लास। सो अगेन टुडे ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर फ्रॉम साइंस एंड टेक। दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। फॉर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेज, रिसेंटली रिसर्चर्स एट IIT मद्रास डेवलप मटेरियल्स विद द ऑप्टो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्रॉपर्टीज। कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इन दिस रिगार्ड। द फर्स्ट सेज, ऑप्टो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इज द स्टडी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस that source, detect and control light. So this statement is correct. The second says, optoelectronic materials find application in optical fiber communication. This statement is also correct. Both statement 1 and 2 are correct. C is the correct answer. Now let us see some questions. What is this optoelectronics? Optoelectronics is study and application of electronic devices that source, detect and control light. Now materials such as tungsten are being studied keenly for their optoelectronic properties, that is a combination of optics and electronics. That's all. We'll move to the next question. Now question number 2 is on Manav Human Atlas. The first statement says, it aims at creating a database network of all the tissues in the human body from the available scientific literature. This statement is correct about Manav Human Atlas. The second says, it is funded by Department of Science and Technology. This is wrong because it is being funded by Department of Biotechnology and not Science and Tech. So only A is the correct statement here. So A will be the correct answer here. Now some validations. What is this Manav Human Atlas? So the project aims to create an open an interactive atlas of human biology, compiling, curating and synthesizing data at molecular, cellular, tissue and organismic level and scientific literature and public databases. Now for the first time, Indian scientists will be the mapping every single tissues of human body to have a deeper understanding of the roles of tissues and cells linked to various diseases, with the twin objective of creating a curated research databases on human biology and introducing young Indian brains to the world of biological sciences. The project will be funded by Department of Biotechnology. Now the project aims to capture the human physiology in two stages, that is a normal stage and also in the diseased stage. That's all. Now this question is on Akula class submarine. So Russia will deliver the Akula class submarine to Indian Navy by 2025 for a period of 10 years. How will the induction of this submarine into Navy will benefit India? The first statement says, it uses a nuclear reactor for propulsion, which makes its detection impossible. So that's very correct. In fact, this is one of the major qualities of this Akula class submarine. The second says, it will help India in training Arihant and Arihant class cruises on the SN submarine. This statement is also correct. Both statement 1 and 2 are correct. C is the correct answer. Now what is this Akula class submarine? So Akula class submarine uses a nuclear reactor for propulsion, allowing it to remain underwater for an extended period of time, which makes its detection impossible. Now this class of submarine can be used for multiple tasks like hunting enemy submarines, intelligence surveillance, etc. Now what are the benefits? So it can be deployed at important focal points in Indian Ocean, and thus India will be able to enjoy strategic dynamic of the region, and also the submarine will have a deterrent impact. The induction of SSN will make India an Indian Ocean power with full spectrum of operational capabilities. It is also the symbol of deep Indo-Russia relation, as no other countries in the world have exchanged any nuclear element in defense armament yet. That's all. Now question number 4 is about the International Energy Agency. So the first says, it is a Paris-based autonomous intergovernmental organization established under framework of United Nations. This statement is wrong because International Energy Agency is a Paris-based autonomous intergovernmental organization established in the framework of OECD in 1974 in the wake of 1973 oil crisis and not by UN. The second says, it works for the promotion of alternative energy resources. So this statement is correct, and since we have to choose the incorrect statement, so A will be the correct answer here. Fine. Now some validation. So what is this project is all about? So IEA was initially dedicated to responding to physical disruption in the supply of oil, as well as serving as an information source on statistics about international oil market and other energy sectors. Now the agency's mandate has broadened to focus on the three E's, that is of effectual energy policy, then energy security, and also economic development and environmental protection. Now IEA has a broad role in promoting alternative energy sources, including renewable energy, rational energy policies and multinational energy technology cooperation. That's all. We'll move to question number 5 here. So International Rice Research Institute, that is IRRI, has recently developed a biofortified crop that is golden rice. In this regard, consider the following statement. The first statement says, biofortification improves the nutrition quality of food crops through agronomic practices. This statement is obviously correct. This statement is correct. The second says, golden rice is the first purposefully created biofortified food to address zinc deficiency. This statement is wrong because it addresses vitamin A deficiency and not zinc deficiency. The third says, IRRI is an intergovernmental organization dedicated to reduce poverty and hunger through rice sciences. This statement is also wrong because it is not an intergovernmental organization, but it is simply an independent non-profit research and educational institute. So that's only one is correct answer here. So A will be the correct answer. So what is this golden rice? So golden rice is a new type of rice that contains beta carotene, that is pro vitamin A, which is converted into vitamin A as needed by the body and gives the grain its golden color. Now it is developed through genetic engineering and produces two enzymes that complete the beta carotene expression in the rice grain. That's all. So question number 6 is here. So question number 6 is about compressed biogas. So the question says, it is exactly similar to the commercially available natural gas in its composition. So this statement is correct. The second says, SETERT initiative has been launched to set up compressed biogas production plants. This statement is also correct. Both statement 1 and 2 are correct. C is the correct answer. Now what is biogas? So you might be knowing, it's a very easy concept. So biogas is produced naturally through a process of anaerobic decomposition from waste biomass production like agriculture residue, cattle dung, sugarcane pressed mud, municipal solid waste, sewage treatment plant, etc. Now after purification, it is composed and called compressed bio, not compost, sorry, it is compressed, and it is called compressed biogas, which has pure methane content of over 95%. Now what is this SETERT initiative? So SETERT initiative had been launched by the government to set up compressed biogas production plants and make available compressed biogas plants in the market for the use in the automotive fuel. That's all. Now question number 7 is here. So consider the following statement regarding gravitational lensing. The first is, it is a natural phenomena that magnifies light around the galaxies. This statement is correct. The second says, it is based on Einstein theories of general relativity. This statement is also correct. Both 1 and 2 are correct. So C is the correct answer. Now what is this gravitational lensing? So gravitational lensing is a natural phenomena that magnifies light around galaxies. The phenomena occurs when a huge amount of matter such as massive galaxy or cluster of galaxies creates a gravitational field and distorts and magnifies the light from objects behind it, but in the same line of sight. Now this makes dim far away object then otherwise would be undetectable, like an individual star visible. The effect allows researchers to study details of early galaxies too far away to be seen otherwise with even with the most powerful scope. Now gravitational lensing is based on the Einstein theory of relativity, that is mass band light. That's all. We'll move to the question number 8. Now question number 8 is about recently K-12 education transformation framework, which has been launched in India. The first is, India the first country in which this model has been launched. So this statement is wrong because India is not the first country, because this model has been adopted by over 50 countries in the world. The second says, this program is launched by Google. So it is wrong. This is not the program of Google, but this is the program of Microsoft. So both statement 1 and 2 are incorrect. We have to choose the incorrect statement. So D will be the correct answer. Sorry, not D. Incorrect choose. So C will be the correct answer here. Now what is this K-12 education transformation framework? So Microsoft has launched its K-12 education transformation framework to facilitate comprehensive digital transformation of schools in India, a model which has been adopted in over 50 countries. Now the framework comprises four pillars, that is leadership and policy, modern teaching and learning, intelligence environment, and technology blueprint. To help the students, principals, and all, the Microsoft is going to hold a series of workshops based on the above pillars. That's all. So we'll move to the question number 9 now. So question number 9 says, Nipah virus outbreak was reopened in Kerala recently. Consider the following statements. First says, it is a zootonic virus with no human to human transmission. This statement is wrong because it is a zoonotic virus, but human to human transmission is also possible. The second says, it was the first recognized during an outbreak among pig farmers in Uganda. This statement is also wrong because it was first recognized in 1999 during an outbreak among pig farmers in Malaysia. The third statement says pigs act as a natural host for Nipah virus. This is very easy to guess. This is also wrong because fruit bats of the family, particularly species belonging to the Platypus genus, are natural host for Nipah virus. So all the statement 1, 2 and 3 are wrong here. So we have to choose incorrect statement. So D will be the correct answer. Now the last question of this class. So the last question is about OSIRIS-REx. Is a planetary science mission for NASA's New Frontiers program. So this statement is correct. The second says OSIRIS-REx is the first ever mission to collect sample from an asteroid and bring it to the Earth. This statement is wrong because it is not the first mission to collect the sample from asteroid. But in June 2010, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency Hayabusa probe returned asteroid samples to the Earth. So only one is the correct answer here. So A will be the correct answer. That's all for today. So today was the last class of science and tech. In fact, we have covered almost all the classes. We have covered polity, international relations, science and tech, environment, culture, economics, everything we have covered. So tomorrow the last class will be there, the day 50, and in that class I will take some general MCQs, current affairs of the areas which are very recent in origin. So that's all for today. I hope you like the class. Have a good day. Thank you very much.